ABC premiere presentation, Mario and the Mob, next.
You know, wearing these bulletproof vests, they make you look bulky.
You don't look bulky.
No, I look bulky. You spend this much money on a suit, you don't want to look bulky.
Trust me, you need these things as protection. You don't look bulky.
I feel bulky.
Look at my rear. My rear's sticking out.
I'm not looking at your rear.
I'm telling you, my rear's sticking out. I can feel it.
Hey, there are other rears I'd rather be looking at. Yours is not one of them.
Fine, you'll think that later. I'm telling you, I still feel bulky.
Well, maybe you're too bulky to push the elevator button.
Never too bulky to push the button.
But it's my turn.
No, it's my turn. I push you coming up, I push you going down. That's one whole turn.
Fine. But I'm driving the car.
All right, you come to a four-way intersection. There's two other cars. Who's got the right of way?
They got guns?
No, they don't got guns.
I do.
Yeah, I got an itch under my vest.
Yeah? You know my dad? My dad told me before he died, he never had to wear a vest.
That's sort of why your dad died.
Oh, yeah.
Kind of takes the fun out of it.
Sure does.
Yeah, boss, we see him.
Hey, show him who's number one.
Absolutely.
Iceman cometh.
So that's Mario Dante.
Oh, that's him, all right.
Just a second, sweetheart. Just a second. You are so grouchy today, really.
Hey, Vincent's my boss. He's also my friend. So we're here. But I don't have to pretend I'm at a Sox game.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. How do you figure that?
Lucky guess.
Nah, they got little ears everywhere. Hey, Carbonero, doesn't the FBI have anything better to do with their Saturdays?
Don't get yourself in
That doesn't make sense. Both those boys are licensed to carry.
You guys didn't get lunch today or something?
How about if I get a drink or something?
No, we talk about this, huh?
You guys.
What, we don't get to drive?
Get in the car.
Thank you.
I knew something was screwing you.
All right.
By Frank Paolo.
Right at the corner, and don't miss.
Hold the fort. Don't make a call until somebody takes a bullet. Again, Jimmy.
Me too. Same as him.
You don't drink.
I'm gonna learn how, okay? It's all your fault.
Everything's my fault. The homeless, the price of oil, it's all my fault.
Do you really hate those kids that much?
Alice, let me tell you something. I want to make a confession, like in church, just between you and me.
Yeah?
It's not these kids in particular. I mean, they're okay, I guess, as kids go. It's all kids. I don't know what to do with them or how to act. And I have never not known what to do or how to act. Never.
That's your confession.
Right.
Okay, here's your penance. I don't like what you're doing or saying, but I like you. A whole lot. So I'll stick.
Thank you very much, Alice.
But in the time those kids got left...
Hey, wait a minute. You talk like they're on death row or something.
For the next week or 2 weeks or whatever, their uncle and his lady are gonna give them something to remember Chicago by. And I'm talking quality time. Deal?
Deal.
Right. Two more. Ready.
Make them double. It's a quick learner, huh? You did good, Alice. You did good.
Oh, Mary.
I'm David Brinkley. On our This Week program Sunday, Space Flight, after some hard years of success, we'll have the shuttle commander, the head of NASA, and a critic who says it's all a waste.
This is Bob Saget. Join me as we give away another 100 grand, show you hilarious new videos and fan mail favorites on an all-new $100,000 edition of America's Funniest Home Videos, Sunday.
Now stay tuned for the season finale of The Commish.
Fuggevo, fuggevo, ora si inebriavo l'ora.